You know, this day might have gone better had I not agreed to go out with Jared. Now look where we are. Instead of Comic-Con, we're inside an auditorium where an actress named Eve just committed mass genocide. But you know what they say, right? When life gives you lemons, you pull out your Beretta M84F, especially if your partner Jared isn't thinking about your safety and well-being. But while Jared is at home crying to his rich dad, Aya and I are going to go look for Eve so that she doesn't burn anyone else to death. We are, after all, better than Jared. We dislike Jared so much that we want to do whatever it takes to not be like him. Okay, but Jared and I talked to each other for an entire 2 weeks before I agreed on a date with him. That makes us practically engaged, right? Actually, you know what? That's all in the past now. I'm over him. Really, really, I am. Anyway, we are currently wearing some pretty uncomfortable shoes. Having said that, our original plan was to run home and grab some sneakers before going after Eve, but the traffic out there, it's still horrible. So we're gonna have to wait until there are less cars on the road. In the meantime, if we're lucky, maybe we'll find a pair of super comfortable Nike Frees on our way to Eve. But before we go, let's open this chest sitting on the side here. Hopefully it contains something helpful. Just one? We just jumped into a deep hole, even though our shoes have little to no shock absorbers. Not sure how I'm gonna explain this to my physical therapist. Are you alone? It's dangerous here. You should go. That girl? It couldn't be. Yeah, I don't know what to do with that information, Aya, so why don't we just keep going? And put the Ghostbusters on speed dial. Oh, you know what? I had rats like this in my home not too long ago. The exterminators I hired, two of them died trying to get rid of these things. Fire damage too, come to think of it, but thankfully my homeowner's insurance covered all that. I did have to lie to them though, since they don't cover rodent infestations. I just told them I had a power surge. Jesus! Did Eve do that to the rat? What is going on here? Oh, so those rats were transformed by Eve? They're her weaponized slaves? Wow, all this time I thought they were native to New York, which happens to be one of the most rat-filled cities in the US. Here, take it. Take everything. It's all on the counter. Okay, sweet. Could you put your shoes on the counter too then? I mean, we happen to be looking for more comfortable footwear, and don't scare me! I'm with the NYPD! You're the one that scared me, lady! I was just getting ready. I'm really sorry. I watched Stephen King's It just recently, and I haven't looked at clowns the same since. God damn it, Aya! We almost had his shoes! You couldn't let me be a dirty cop for just 30 more seconds! You know, only staff are allowed in here. There was an incident here. You'll have to evacuate. What? You're kidding, right? Hey, I'm not dying here tonight. See ya. Okay, but the rats here aren't native to New York. In fact, I did apologize for scaring him earlier, right? Okay, my conscience is clear then. He had bullets in his locker? Oh, he must have bought them after encountering too many people who watched clown-based horror films. Oh, now I feel really bad. How are his shoes doing, though? Okay, that clown's body has got to be around here somewhere. Yes, I said body because I doubt he survived. He left his bullets in his locker, for crying out loud. It's that clown from the dressing room. Oh, jeez. He's been burned all over. Where are his shoes, though? Because all I see are a couple of charred and oddly shaped feet. Wait, could they really have... Did those pyromaniac rats take his shoes? And did they take his shoes knowing that Aya and I won them for... You know, so that we could walk and run more comfortably? Come to think of it, I did kill one of those rats earlier, didn't I? Oh my god, taking the shoes must have been their way of retaliating. Well, in that case, I will go John Wick on all of you until someone surrenders that clown's shoes to me. My feet are getting sore, but at least I got a heel liner on my left foot. My right foot might develop a blister soon, though. Yeah, I don't follow. Okay, my feet are feeling less sore now. I can keep going. For now, at least. On another note, I lost count as to how many rats I've put down so far, but I suppose I could consider a ceasefire if I find a pair of Nike Frees in one of these lockers here. I'll be with you in just a minute. I just gotta open this one last locker. Empty. Screw that ceasefire. I'm gonna exterminate each and every one of those pyromaniac mother friends. How are you holding up? You're still alive. Hold on. Let me call the paramedics. Melissa. She's a monster. Don't try to talk now. Melissa? Melissa? You mean the main actress? She probably got to Suzanne, too. You'll have to stop her. No, please wake up. Hang in there. Rest in peace, friend. May you wake up in a beautiful paradise with unburned feet and a pair of comfortable Nike Frees. Locked? I guess those pyromaniac rats overheard me when I changed my mind about that ceasefire. Now they're hiding from me, locking themselves in these rooms. You can't hide from me forever. Sooner or later, I will find you. And when I do, you will hand over that clown's obnoxiously red shoes.
You'll never take us alive!
Oh, this room is actually unlocked. Does that mean none of those rats are hiding in here? Cowering in fear of my presence? Those rats kept this room unlocked on purpose! Oh god, now someone's burned skin is all over my cocktail dress, and it's still hot! Is that a phone? Oh god, I don't know who to call. My therapist or my local dry cleaners. I need disinfectant wipes. I need antibacterial soap. There has got to be something in this room I can use to wipe off this nastiness. Now both my heels are protected from blisters, but that's not gonna do anything for the burnt skin on my dress. I am beginning to smell like burgers. Hot! Hot! Help! Help! Oh my god. Thank you so much for talking me through that panic attack I just had. You validated my feelings with so few words. Yet the emotion behind them was boundless. You're so empathetic. In fact, I think I've just found a new therapist for myself. I will never forget you, Therapy Bird. A diary? November 3rd. Monday. The Christmas show is set. This has been my dream. The main actress has a solo concert in the theater at Central Park. I took all that medication to get here. I have to get the lead part. I'll even sell my soul to the devil if I have to. November 17th, Monday. The cast was announced. And Suzanne and I are double cast. I want to play the part alone, but everybody knows she's good. November 21st, Friday. I think I'm overdoing it. My body's getting hotter than ever for some reason. I'd better take more medicine. Okay, so it sounds like this person gets hot flashes just like I do. That reminds me. December 6th, Saturday. I collapsed today. I lost consciousness after my body got hot. I don't care if I die. I just want to get through this show. Did you hear that? At least give her an ice pack then. December 10th, Wednesday. I passed out again. They told me to go to the doctor and get some rest. If this continues, Suzanne will definitely take my part. I need to get better. I'd better take a lot of medication tonight. December 11th, Thursday. Suzanne was burned in an apartment fire. Is it because I wanted the part so bad? God forgive me. I guess Suzanne didn't have an ice pack either. Okay, but didn't you just say you were contractually obligated to cater to me? December 17th, Wednesday. It looks like I'll be the lead. I'd better take more medication and work it. December 23rd, Tuesday. Opening night. Everything went smoothly. Tomorrow is Christmas Eve. We should have the biggest crowd of the season. So we're not in October? Which means Comic-Con wasn't happening today after all? And I have the solo concert the next day at the park. But I'm not feeling well. I'd better shape up if I want to get through this. I'd better take more medication. For what? Why is she taking so much? She must have a drug problem. Yeah, what Aya said. Can you spare a therapy session for whoever wrote this diary? Oh, it's Therapy Bird again. Is it time for my next session already? I mean, either way, you're a lot cheaper than my previous therapist, especially since you only accept payment in fruit. Merry Christmas!
Goodbye!
Therapy Bird, what's wrong? You're not yourself. No. Eve did this to you, didn't she? In the same way that she created those pyromaniac rats? Why? Why? Hi, everybody. I'm Dcobra, and I hope my humor helped make your day. If it did, then do please let me know by liking the video. If you'd like me to thank you personally, or if you want to talk about how Therapy Bird changed your life, you can leave a comment on this video as well. Lastly, do you want YouTube to let you know whenever I have a new video? If so, the most convenient way to make that happen is to subscribe to my channel. Again, thank you so much for watching, and I hope to hear from you.